Hey there, this is Ilze Be. I am a Latvian and I teach Latvian to English speakers. Welcome to day 23 of my Latvian challenge, 4 words a day. Today I'm going to teach you a little bit of grammar, explaining a little bit more of the Latvian grammar than I have done before. And this is because of my student Ina's questions after my yesterday's video, where I taught you the sentence mani interesē sports, kultūra un politika. So Ina asked about the word mani because she had noticed that before I taught a phrase where I said man, and she was asking if the difference between mani and man is gender-based. So I wanted to answer this question publicly. No, it is not gender-based. It has to do with the structure of the sentence. Mani actually means me, and man means to me. So whenever you want to say that you are interested in something, you should use mani, no matter whether you are a male or a female. However, today I have a sentence in which I will use the word man. And also, yesterday I taught you that if you put a prefix ne in front of a verb, you get a negative form. Namely, if you mean to say I am interested in, you say mani interesē. But if you mean to say I am not interested in, then you say mani neinteresē. Today I will tell you that you can also add a prefix ja in front of verbs, and then you will have a form in which you would express a need. So today's sentence in English would sound like this. I need to study pronunciation and understand grammar. And in Latvian it sounds like this. Man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. The rhythm of this sentence is no, yes, no, no, yes, no, 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 yes, no, no, yes, no, no, no. I'll repeat the sentence again. Man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. Let's start from the last word, and I think it will not be difficult because it is somewhat similar to the English word. That Latvian word is grammatika. Grammatika. It is a four-syllable word, and therefore I will start to teach it to you from the last syllable. And the last syllable is ka. Ka. Let's repeat it. Ka. Very simple, right? So I think we can switch to the syllable that stands before the syllable, ka. And that syllable is ti. Ti. Let's repeat it. Ti. Very well. Let's put those two syllables together. That would sound like this. Ti. Ka. Ti. Ka. Can we pronounce it together? Let's do it. Ti. Ka. Let's say it again. Ti. Ka. The syllable that stands before the syllable ti is ma. Ma. Let's pronounce it together. Ma. And once more. Ma. And now let's pronounce the last three syllables together. Matika. Matika. Can we say it together? Let's do it. Matika. And once more. Matika. Very well. And now let's add the first syllable to the word. And that first syllable is gra. Gra. Let's repeat it. Gra. Very well. Now the whole word. Grammatika. 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 The stress is on the first syllable. Gra. Grammatika. Let's pronounce it together. Grammatika. Once more. Grammatika. And now you independently. And the word that stands before the word grammatika is jāsaprot. Jāsaprot. And if you have studied some Latvian before, you would maybe remember the word saprot or saprotu or saproti. This word means to understand, but since we have a prefix jā, then it means need to understand. Jāsaprot. Jāsaprot. There is a diphthong o in the last syllable of this word. Jāsaprot. And there is the long vowel a in the first syllable of this word. Jāsaprot. I'd like us to pronounce this word together. Jāsaprot. Jāsaprot. As you notice, the stress is on the first syllable. Jāsaprot. Are you ready to say it by yourself? Please do it. Wonderful. Can we say the last two words together? They would sound like this. Jāsaprot gramatika. Let's try to do it. Let's try pronouncing them together. Jāsaprot gramatika. Let's do it again. Jāsaprot gramatika. Very well. And the word that stands before the word jāsaprot is the word un. It's that simple word that we have used a lot lately. Un. Let's say it together. Un. And now I think we are ready to pronounce the last three words. And they are un jāsaprot gramatika. The word un is not stressed, so the rhythm would be no, yes, no, no, yes, no, no, no. Un jāsaprot gramatika. No, yes, no, no, yes, no, no, no. Un jāsaprot gramatika. Very well. Let's say it together. Un jāsaprot gramatika. And the word that stands before the word un is izruna. 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 This is a three-syllable word, but if it didn't have the first syllable is, which actually is a prefix, then the word would be runa, and then it would mean speech. But this word izruna means pronunciation. Once more, izruna, izruna. Let's pronounce it together. Izruna. Once more, izruna. And again, izruna. Very well, and I think that you can pronounce it by yourself. Excellent. So now we need to learn the word that stands before the word izruna, and that word is jāmācās. This is a three-syllable word, but if we didn't have the first syllable jā, then it would mean learn. But since there is the first syllable jā, then it means need to learn. Jāmācās. Jāmācās. There is that difficult consonant c in this word. And there are also three long a sounds. Jāmācās. All the vowels are long. A. Jāmācās. But the stress is on the first syllable. Jāmācās. Which doesn't affect the remaining two syllables in terms of the length of the vowels. They all still are long. Jāmācās. Let's pronounce it together. Jāmācās. And again. Jāmācās. And once more. Jāmācās. Very well. And now the word that stands before the word jāmācās. And that word is man. Man. We have learned this word already. In this sentence, when we translate the sentence altogether, we would translate it as I, because we are going to say I need to, but the word separately would mean to me. This is just because of the sentence structure, because Latvians express this thought differently. We have different reasoning about how to express the need. So whenever you want to express a need to do something, you would use the word man, and then the verb that will follow will have the prefix ja. Like in this case, man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. And this is our sentence. I'll say it again, and then I invite you to say it together with me. Listen carefully. Man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. All right, let's try to read it together. Man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. Let's do it again. Man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. I'll pronounce it now in a normal native Latvian's rhythm and pace. Man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. This is the pace that you should be striving for. I'll pronounce it once more. Man jāmācās izruna un jāsaprot gramatika. I'm so glad that you are still sticking with me. So I'll see you tomorrow on day 24 of my Latvian challenge, 4 words a day. But now I'll say uz redzēšanos, atā!